You may have the Rolex watches, but we have the time. Kahit nakarelo ka, wala ka ng oras. Kasi namamatay na siya. Ang mahalaga sa atin, kahit wala tayong Rolex, o anuman yung mahal na relo, alam niyo, mas mahal sa Rolex. Ang mahalaga, we still have the time. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Rolex and time. I'm not promoting the product. Total naman, masyadong mahal yun. Hindi naman natin yata regularly ginagamit. Anyway. When I was a young priest, I celebrated Mass in a very organized parish. Gusto kong nagmimisa dun sa parokyang yon because that parish is very professional, very efficient, very organized, sabi ko nga. It always starts on time. May mga parokyang minsan nagmimisa ko rin. Nung wala pa po akong parokya, nung nasa social action pa ako, minsan nandyan ka na, wala pa yung nagbabasa, wala pa yung commentator, wala pa yung choir. Parang, but that parish is very efficient, very organized, very clean and very neat. Gustong-gusto kong nagmimisa doon as a guest priest. Sa katagalan ko nagmimisa doon, pamilyar na ako sa mga tao. Kamukha dito. Minsan, after a Sunday Mass, Sunday po yung assignment ko, one of the Sunday Masses, lumapit sa akin yung isang matandang lector, senior, elderly lector. Regular siya nagbabasa. Sabi niya sa akin, "Father, one time, I failed to fulfill my Sunday schedule." May assignment sila. "And I also failed to inform the officers a day before. Hence, there was a glitch in the high mass during that Sunday liturgy." Usually kasi, magkakaroon ng problema. O mismong misa na, wala pa yung reader. Parang misa nangyari din dito yan. And then, syempre, emergency, they will pull somebody to read. She knew and expected and accepted that the policy of the organization, yung COMLEC, commentator lectors, and the policy of the parish to instill discipline among the members, that she will be automatically disqualified from serving as a lector for 1 year. Ganyan din po sa mga altar boys, ganyan din sa mga commentators, even sa mga choir. It is a policy among organizations and the parish. You have to go through a seminar, refresher, and wait for 1 year to be reinstated before you can go back serving the altar again. That's why she was not serving for more than a year, for almost a year. Tapos bigla po siyang umiyak. Sabi ko, bakit po kayo umiyak? Kasi, Father, they did not even ask why I did not come. And they did not even ask why I failed to inform my officers a day before. No one bothered to ask the question, what happened? Why I failed my assignment? Why I failed to inform my officers a day before? Matanda na po kung nagsiserve sa simbahan. Hindi naman po ako nalilate. Hindi naman po ako pumapalya. Kung talaga hindi ako makakarating, magnininang ako sa kasal o makikipag-birthday ako, I would inform them. But Father, they never ask me. The policy was simply implemented. Umiyak na po siyang umiyak. Sabi ko, bakit po kayo umiyak? Alam niyo po, Father, ba di ako nakarating noon? Matanda na kaming mag-asawa, alam nyo naman po. Almost 65 na yung mag-asawa. Yung asawa ko, malaking lalaki. Kaming dalawa lang sa bahay. Yung anak ko, may sariling pamilya na. Na-stroke po yung asawa ko madaling araw ng Sunday. kaming dalawa lang sa bahay. Hindi ko po alam paano ko idadala sa ospital ang asawa ko. Hindi naman po ako marunong mag-drive. Hindi ko po mabuhat ang asawa ko. Tumakbo po ako dun sa may mala entrance ng ating subdivision para makakuha ng tricycle at dinala ko po sa emergency hospital ang asawa ko early Sunday morning. And then umiyak na po siyang umiyak. Nobody even asked me what happened. And nobody even visited us in the hospital. Wala pa pong COVID noon, matagal na to. I realize the church, our parish, it's not primarily an organization. Jesus did not leave an organization. I doubt even if he really established a church as an organized faith. But primarily, Jesus knew that he was leaving a living body of himself, a living body of Christ, as we experience it now and here. Here and now. Buhay na katawan ni Kristo. Ang katawan ni Kristo, nagmamahal sa Diyos, nagmamahal sa kapwa, kung paano pagmamahal sa sarili. That our church is not an organization. Napansin ko dito sa simbahan natin, our first experience of involving ourselves fully in the church, other than going to church every Sunday or weekdays, you are invited to join an organization. Lector, commentator, EMDC, maybe Apostolado ng Panalangin, COMI, and other organizations of our own church in different ministries. It can even be Couples for Christ. You can mention more organizations. But you realize more than our organization is we are called to be representatives of the body of Christ. I am part of a bigger body. It's not about an organizational chart. Nung bata-bata akong pare, tsaka seminarista, nakikita ko sa bawat parokya, mayroong sasalubong sa'yo sa mga sacristy o office ng sekretarya, organizational chart. President, vice president, treasurer, mga officer. Parang it's very organized. Actually, I agree with that. We have to be organized. But sometimes there are issues about positions, titles, functions. We are measured by being effective or being efficient. Kamukha ng parokya, they have good policies, but they fail to be the living body of Christ. It's not about only you becoming an efficient lector, commentator, or a president of your organization, attendance, uniform. But it's about caring, living together as one, as friends. You are my friends, sabi ni Jesus. And that is the kind of celebration that we have every day. I may be a priest, yes, but this is just a function. I have to serve you as a priest. But more than that, I hope I'll be your friend, a companion, a person who cares about you also, and most especially. Minsan may isang anak, kamamatay ng tatay niya. Malungkot na malungkot itong anak. Kasi yung ibang kapatid niya, namanin nila bahay, yung iba lupa, yung isa tindahan. Ang kanyang namana, lumang kotse. An old car. Of course, he did not appreciate it. He was even angry. Why? Mang kapatid ko, bahay, lupa, tindahan. Ako, lumang kotse. The old friend of his father asked, why the son did not appreciate his inheritance? The son said, did you not realize my brothers have a house, have a business, have a store, and even a land? But me, he gave me this old junk car. Tanda-tandang sasakyan na luma. And I went to a junk shop. I asked them to assess it. Lalo ako nalungkot. It was very cheap. The friend of his father said, itong kaibigan ng tatay niya, kumpare niya, I think you do not appreciate the value of the car of your father. You do not know what he really gave you. And you went to the wrong place. Kaya nga naman kasi naging mura ang sasakyan ng tatay mo, idinala mo sa junk shop. Of course, pag may dinala ka sa junk shop, ano yung tingin sa dinala mo? Junk! Basura! It's something that is to be thrown away. Kaya nga mura. Kasi you ask it to be measured from that perspective. A junk shop. Sabi ng kaibigan ng tatay niya, I want you to go to this antique shop collector. Idala mo yung sasakyan ng tatay mo sa kanila. And you will see the value, the true value of your daddy's car. And you will be surprised. It's worth a fortune. It's more expensive than the house, the land, and that store. Umisan po kasi we have to clarify our values. Hindi naman kung ano lang nakikita ng mata, yun na. It can be a beautiful church. Actually, inaayos natin simbahan natin. Pinapintura natin yung dun site, pinapintura natin dito sa site. Naka-deliver na po yung mga tiles natin, lalagay nila sana. It's not about that. Jesus is so angry with the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the scribes, and even called them 3 times, woe to you! Parang you do not see the value of what we are celebrating. You miss the point. It's not the gold in the temple. It's not the offering in the temple. It's not how many converts you did or you had. It's about the experience of what makes all of this sacred. Ang pagpapahalaga at ang tunay na halaga ng ating pananampalataya. Mayroon isang cartoon movie, yung Barnyard. Mga animals po yung mga main actors dito. One of them characters, si Daisy, the cow, sabi niya, the best leader is not necessarily the strongest, but the best leader is somebody who cares most. Totoo naman po yan eh. Hindi naman yung ano sinabi ng survey, ano sinabi ng maraming tao dahil marami kong media, ano ito, yung talagang social media outlets and support. It's about the sincerity of the person. We have to see that. We have to value more than face value, more than what others would say, but to discover truly the value of each person. Kaya dyan po tayo pupunta sa title ng ating reflection. Minsan po may mayaman na tao. Dahil napakayaman niya, he wasted his time in a life of dissipation. Good time, worldly pleasure, power struggle, and even put down a lot of people because of that. At marami sa pamilya niya nasaktan dahil sa ginagawa niya. During his deathbed, dahil mayaman po siya, suit-suit niya yung pinakamahal na Rolex. Hindi ko po alam ilan milyon. Alam nyo naman po yung mga relo ngayon, kahit hindi Rolex, kumisan 13 million, 15 million, di ba kumisan? Nakikita natin sa mga dyaryo kung gaano kamahal yung relo ng mga tao ngayon. Sabi daw nung isang onlooker, di ko alam, ordinary person in the room while the rich man was dying. You may have the Rolex watches, but we have the time. Kahit nakarelo ka, wala ka ng oras. Kasi namamatay na siya. Ang mahalaga sa atin, kahit wala tayong Rolex, o anuman yung mahal na relo, alam niyo, mas mahal sa Rolex. Ang mahalaga, we still have the time. Let us celebrate that in a proper value. Let us not miss the point, like the scribes, the Pharisees, and the Sadducees that are being challenged by Jesus as hypocrites. Let this be our good news. Let this be our celebration. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.